through the current order book of the GVOL suite data analytics. So if you look on the left-hand side here, you can see the different venues of data that we have, whether it's Deribit, Bitcom, and some other ones in the future. So right now on the current order book tab, which is our free tier, what you'll first see is the volatility skews. So you're looking at the x-axis, all the different strike prices, and then on the y-axis, you will see the implied volatility for those strike prices. You can go ahead and look at the bid and the ask instead of the midpoint vol or the mark vol. And then you can also look at different kind of views of this volatility skew. So you can look at the delta view, which what this does is that instead of looking at strike prices on the x-axis, we're going to go ahead and aggregate volatility into delta buckets. So this 10 delta put, for example, is trading 56 implied vol. Something else we can do is look at the at-the-money ratio. So what this does is that it sets at-the-money vol equal to 1. And now the same delta put is looking to be 41% more expensive in terms of implied vol. So it changes this y-axis to be relative implied vol instead of absolute implied vol. Scrolling down here, we can see the order book term structure. So this is going to be at the money volatility for all the different expirations. So we could see how the different expiration months measure up in terms of at the money vol. This forward volatility in blue here is going to tell us the differential between any two expiration points. So for example, this October 30th implied vol, which is currently trading at 47%, versus this November 27th, which is trading 55. Well, that extra, call it 30 days, this forward vol is telling us that that extra 30 days is costing 62 implied vol. So that 30 days between the 30th to the 27th is bringing up the whole average for November to 55. So that's what this forward volatility is telling us. And it really gives us the differential vol between any two expirations. Here we see the current day's activity. So this is not 24 hours. This flips over to each new calendar day. So right now we're looking at call premium bought, call premium sold, put bought, put sold, all in terms of the dollar value of premium. We can go ahead and click this and look at it in terms of contracts. And the reason why this would differ sometimes is that, let's say an option that's way deep in the money, that's going to cost a lot of premium, even though it's only one contract, versus, you know, something that has, you know, less than 0.1 delta, way out of the money options. A lot of those can trade in terms of contracts, but it won't cost a lot of premium. Scrolling down some more, we can see the open interest picture. So right now we're looking at open interest for the whole Bitcoin option space on Deribit. And we can see this aggregated by different views. So whether it's calls versus puts, open interest by different strikes, by different expirations, open interest by different strikes. And we can go ahead and narrow this down. So let's say we only want to look at long dated options. So let's say we want to look at this June expiration only. So we use this days until expiration filter. It goes ahead and basically recalculates everything for only this June expiration. And so we can see the open interest in terms of calls versus puts or strikes for June. Down here, it's also affected by the slider. So June just released not too long ago. So that's why there's not data, there's missing data. So let me just expand this a little bit bigger so we can do June and call it March. And now we can see basically the combination of these two. We can see 1 hour at the money volatility for the past 30 days. So this is, you know, 1 hour data points over 30 days. And we can see how at the money volatility has reacted throughout the past 30 days. Here we have the 20 to 30 delta skew. So we go ahead and aggregate all the options that have between 20 and 30 deltas. On the call side, we take that implied vol number and we subtract it by the 20 to 30 delta put side, and we get the differential. So something like this reading that says, you know, 7.36, that's telling us that those out of money calls are 7.36 implied vol points richer than the out of the money puts. So that's how we read that. And so we could see how that relationship has progressed throughout the past month. Here we have open interest charts. So we can go ahead and see open interest for up to 3 months. We can see in terms of contracts what open interest has done. We can go ahead and use this days until expiration filter to narrow it down. So let's say we just want to see open interest of all the options that have less than a week till expiration. We can see how that has reacted throughout the past 3 months. Here we can see the open interest for a specific contract. So let's say I want to look at this March expiration. I could see how open interest has progressed. I can go ahead and click 3 months if I want to see that throughout the past 3 months. So right now there's about 20,000 March Bitcoin option contracts out there being traded around. Scrolling down some more, we can see basically the top trades that have occurred through the day in descending size of a dollar value of premium. So the biggest trade today was basically someone bought, on the buy side that is, someone bought almost 15 June $12,000 calls. They paid 30 grand for that. We can go ahead and filter that by sells or block trades, and then liquidations, if there's any liquidations. So you'll see, okay, someone got liquidated. They had to sell their their Bitcoin put, and they sold that, you know, at implied vol 71, so on and so forth. Something to note, one more thing to note is that we have little information bubbles. So you can go ahead and hover over these information bubbles and see basically how things were calculated, as well as an explanation. So you can see in terms of this open interest, you can see, okay, this is basically our explanation for open interest. And here's how we've been calculating it. And that's pretty much it for the current order book tab.